gather here this morning at Arlington National Cemetery, a sacred place. A place that for over 150 years has honored her fallen warriors and patriots. These hallowed grounds are a lasting memorial to men and women who have served our nation. It is the final resting place for over 500,000 men and women. A place that can only be earned and cannot be bought. As you look upon the rows of headstones, each stone is a brick in the foundation of freedom upon which we stand. It's a resting place to receive those who have served faithfully with honor, courage, and commitment. Today, Sergeant Harold Pederson takes his rightful place here in these hallowed grounds. Let us pray. Eternal God, we bless you for the great company of all those who have kept the faith, who have finished their race, and who now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us. Especially we thank you for Pete, whom you received into your presence. Help us to believe where we have not seen, trusting you to lead us through our years. Bring us at last with all your saints in the joy of your home, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. At a time like this, it is good to turn our hearts and minds towards Holy Scriptures, for they are written by men and women who knew what it was to grieve, who knew what it was to say goodbye to a loved one, and who knew what it was to put their faith in God. David writes, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Today we have gathered to celebrate a life well lived, to celebrate a man well loved, to reflect on his gifts to the world, to honor his service to our country, to surround him with our prayers, to reunite him with his wife, and to lay him to rest. Pete was born November 26, 1927 in Minnesota, where he was raised. Hearing the call of his country, he joined the United States Marine Corps Reserve and served during the Korean War. Today we stand as a country eternally grateful for his willingness to put himself in harm's way. Morning, as we render military honors through the firing of rifles, the playing of taps, the presentation of the flag, it is a small way that we can say thank you. Thank you for his courage, thank you for his devotion to duty. In addition to his service with the Marine Corps, he worked with the Department of the Navy as a program analyst in D.C. and later worked for the Department of the Army, moving to Sierra Vista, Arizona in 1969. In 1964, fell in love with and married Dolores. The two were married for 56 years before her passing in 2020. Today is a bittersweet day, as although we are saying goodbye to Pete, we are reuniting him with the love of his life. Pete was a man of faith who served his church faithfully, serving as a Gideon to help spread the gospel, passing away February 7th, 2020. Today, as we pause to reflect on his life, we think of the wonderful impact on those he's had around him. Think of the wonderful life that he led, and we just say in our hearts, well, that was just marvelous. Today, we lay to rest a Marine, a husband, a friend, a brother, and we ask that each one of us would find comfort during this time of grief. And more importantly, we ask that our lives would be blessed for having known him. Today, as you have gathered as family and friends, we gather with you as your military family. As we honor his service, we say one last time. Semper Fidelis, Marine. You stand relieved. We have the horse.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for military honors. The firing party is in front of you to the right. Buglers over to the left.
Detail, attend, hut!
Ready! Aim! Fire!
Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you.
sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. May the Almighty God, our brother, commit his ashes in the ground, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, says the Spirit. They rest from their labors, and their works follow them. Merciful God, you heal the broken in heart and bind up the wounds of the afflicted. Strengthen us in our weakness, calm our troubled spirits, and dispel our doubts and fears. In Christ rising from the dead, you conquered death and opened the gates to everlasting life. Renew our trust in you that by the power of your love, we shall one day be brought together again with our brothers and friends. We pray for Jesus Christ our Lord. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord's countenance be upon you and bring you peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this does conclude our service today. It was my absolute privilege to be here with you and your loved ones. If any of you